Have you heard me preach? Tell them was a neighbor.
Neighbor.
You are the next in the line.
You are the next in the line.
Say the Lord will visit you.
The Lord will visit you.
Say it does not matter your mistakes.
It does not matter your mistakes.
Say God will see beyond that mistake. And make you who He has made you to be. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you see how God operates? We saw last week how Gideon, a man who was afraid. You see, hear me? That's what the Bible says, by strength shall no man prevail. You see, God's choice is not based on your physical strength. Hallelujah. That was why when He sent Samuel to go and anoint the king in the house of Jesse, you know, they brought some big men, men who had muscle, men who we are doing gym. But God said, I have not chosen them. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? The Lord looks at your heart. Yes, I am caught up in this mistake. But there is a chance for you.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? I don't know why I'm going this way. Hallelujah. Yes, I have been subsumed in this mistake. But Jehovah will save me my mistake and anoint me for my purpose. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm getting blessed, church.
Yes,
he said, come now, therefore, I will send you to Pharaoh, that you may bring my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. Let's go ahead quickly. Let's go with me. Patient with me. He said, but Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and that I should bring the children of Israel out of Egypt? Do you know what God is doing here? You may be God, if you're a little boy, God calls you and say, my brother or sister, come. I want to send you to Niklen. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you're a little girl, the Lord called you. Say, I want to send. And you begin to check yourself. Say, me? Are you hearing me? And you know that there is no way they won't even allow you. They won't even give you access. That was why he began to negotiate with God there. You see, Moses saw himself in a state. Say, God, how can you send me to Pharaoh? Moses began to see his natural man. But that, hear me, when you see yourself from the eye which God sees you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? Don't allow the flesh to minister to you. You are a child of God. The Bible says there is no condemnation for them who are in Christ Jesus. Are you hearing me? Don't allow the enemy to do what condemns you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm getting blessed. There is no condemnation. God sees you in a different world capacity. Hear me. When God is with you, when God chooses you, He'll be with you. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? Look at what He said there. He said, so He said, I will certainly be with. I'm going to bless you. Don't be distracted. I'm saying something this morning.
Amen.
I will certainly be with you. Watch this. You see, there's something about when God sends you, He will show you a sign. Are you hearing me? When God sends you, He will do what? Show you a sign. When God visits you, there will be signs. You will see some signs, but most times you don't even understand the sign. That's the problem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is showing us signs, but we are not sensitive to the sign He's showing us. Hallelujah. Look at this. He said, I will certainly be with you, and it shall be a sign to you that I have sent you. He said, when you have brought out the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God on this mountain. Let's go quickly. He said, then Moses said to God, indeed, when I come to the children of Israel, and I said to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and I said to me, what is his name? What shall I say to them? I love this God. Are you hearing me? Moses began to engage God. Say, yes, I trust you. I have seen the burning bush. The bush burnt and it wasn't being consumed. But when I'm going to my people, what name shall I give to them as the reference of who has sent me? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord will show you a sign.
Amen.
Look at this. And God said to Moses, I am who I. Do you know what I mean? Your problem does not change God.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Your challenges does not change God. Right. In Jesus Christ. He said, I am who I am. Present continuous tense. Wake me in the morning, I am God. Wake me in the night, I am God. In the evening, I am God. I cannot see you and change. My name is God. I did not fail Elijah. I will not fail you, Moses. I did not fail Elijah. I will not fail you. Tell them, I am, have sent you. Hear me. Your situation cannot change God. There is nothing you have seen that others have not seen. Are you hearing me? No problem you have gone through that no man has ever seen before. Are you hearing me? All I'm come this morning to tell you is that the Lord is about to visit you. But humble yourself under his presence. Hallelujah. He said, Tara, this is my name. I am who I am. Hallelujah. Amen. I will get him blessed. Tell them I am who I am. I was with Elijah. I did not fail him. I was with Elijah. I never failed him. Tell them I am have sent you. Hallelujah. May God send you in the name of Jesus. He said, and he said, thus you shall say to the children of Israel, I am have sent me to you. Hey, may Jehovah be I am in your case.
Amen.
May Jehovah be I am in your situation.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. The trouble we have is that most times we do not have the faith capacity to engage God. Are you hearing me? Why will God say to Moses, I am, I've sent you? Hallelujah. He said, tell them I am who I am. In the days of Abraham, I was. Jacob, I was. Isaac, I was. So tell them I am have. Look at this. He said, the Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever. And this is my memorial to all brethren. There is something about God's visitation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When God visits the situation, that situation does not remain the same. And you see, one thing about God, you see, most time when God comes, he comes in a certain way. Hallelujah. Moses was not expecting this encounter. Am I correct? The Bible said he was taking the sheep of what? Jethro. He was being a very good boy who a wife has been given to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I thank God for thy laws. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know, when you misbehave, they will define your diary for you. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Don't mess about with the father-in-law. Are you hearing me? When you see him, you have to prostrate. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You mess about with him, you collect the wife. And when they see you, your friends will know that something has happened to you. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
I thank God for women, honestly. Hallelujah. A man of God said before he got married, he will wear blue shirt and wear red tie and wear green hat. Everything is fighting. But when the wife came in, he said, hey, let's amend this thing. Are you hearing me? So don't play with the father-in-law. Amen. If you joke with him, that 1-2 days on holidays, you'll be in trouble.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Moses was being a very humble man. He never expected he would encounter Jehovah. But meanwhile, God has packaged him for what? An assignment. Hallelujah. That is why we must live our life with what expectation. You see, for every child of God is a miracle about to manifest. Are you hearing me? For the things that today things have not worked, that does not mean they will not work out. Your God is by your side watching you. Hallelujah. Let that determine how you walk with God. Hear me? Jesus Christ. Maybe if Moses knew that God would visit him, he wouldn't have killed. Are you hearing me? But see, I love God. I love God. I love God. I say it again, he goes beyond your mistakes. Hallelujah. He goes beyond your mistakes. You see, he knows the areas of your weakness. He knows that yes, you cannot pray for 10 hours. But meanwhile, he's still interested in you. Are you hearing me? The Lord will qualify you.
Amen.
The Lord will qualify you.
Amen.
He will visit you suddenly and qualify you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you getting blessed here?
Yes.
Take me to the book of Luke, chapter number 1, from verse 5, quickly. Sudden visitation. When God visits you, every experience about to change. He said, there was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias, of the division of what? Abijah. His wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. He said, and they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren. And they were both well advanced in the age. So it was that while he was serving as a priest before God, in order of what is the vision. Let me give you a bit of background story here. This couple, they were serving Jehovah. But there was still something that was not complete in their life. Are you hearing me? But that did not stop them from doing what serving God. You know, the problem at times, we tend to give up so easily. Hallelujah. And hear me, brethren, in this particular service to God, we are not quitters. Hallelujah. For the fact that something has not happened does not mean it will not happen. Aye, Jesus Christ. Have you ever thought of how you go to bed and sleep for 12 hours and wake up in the morning, you know, you see yourself, you go have a shower and wear clothes and go your way. You think that is just so normal. Until they take it to someone who went and didn't wake up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not meant to quit so easily. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This couple, the Bible said, they were serving them and they were what? Blameless. But meanwhile, there was a situation that was not favorable. Hallelujah. You know, at times the Lord wants to even prepare us, you know, in a point where we'll be able to trust Him. You see, I want to encourage you. Don't serve God because of the blessing. Serve Him because of your love for Him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Don't run after God because of what He's blessing. For blessing, it will come. Hallelujah. Serve Him because you love Him. And let's go ahead. He said, according to the custom of the priesthood, his Lord fell to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of the people was praying outside at the hour of incense. He said, then, look at this. You see, hear me. Most times when the Lord wants to intervene, he intervenes through an angel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, the angels are waiting for you to be what? Stand and take instructions from you. Hallelujah. He said, then an angel appeared unto the Lord. An angel of the Lord appeared unto him, standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled and fear fell upon him. Fear again. All these guys that God visited, they were afraid of. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible didn't say they were standing so strong. But at some point, fear was gripping them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
So don't see your weakness. See the strength of God. That was why Job said, let the weak say, I am strong.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, but then they said to him, do not be afraid, Zacharias, for your prayer is here. And your wife, Elizabeth, will bear you a son. May God answer your prayers.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This man has been praying. You see, he hear me. You see, most times you think the prayers you are praying, God is not hearing. Are you hearing me? I said, for the fact that the answer has not come this morning does not mean it will come tomorrow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Serve God with an expectation. Because when he visits, it is a sudden moment.
Amen.
Hear me, this man did not prepare God to visit him. The Bible said he went to perform a ritual, as it is with a priest. Are you hearing me? Gideon was doing what? Threshing wheat in the toilet when God came. Moses was serving their father-in-law when God came. Zacharias was doing what? Offering incense when God came. the Lord will see you in your bedroom.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
I don't know where God will meet you.
Amen.
But this was never prepared to see God. But suddenly the man showed up.
Amen.
And that became a changing light in their ministry.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord will show up.
Amen.
The Lord will show up.
Amen.
The Lord will show up.
Amen.
The Lord will show up. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, brethren, there is nothing that is too difficult for God to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We may have been praying throughout this year, praying for something, praying. We have fasted. They say 21 days we'll fast and pray. You know, they say 7 days we'll fast and pray. They say 9 days will come. Even we will receive prophecies. Hear me. Wait on the Lord, I say wait. Your time will come. You see, one thing with God, there is no unrighteousness in God. Are you hearing me? And God is attentive to our prayers. Are you hearing me? For the fact it has not come today does not mean tomorrow you will not see the answer to the prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Zacharias did not know that Jehovah will meet him. The Bible said he went to offer incense. According to the tradition of what? The priest. He was minding his own business when the angel of the Lord showed up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May God meet you as you mind your business.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Look at what happened there. And you say, and you shall call his name John, and you will have joy and gladness. And many will rejoice at his birth. Let's go quickly. He said, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will also be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. And will turn many of the children of Israelites towards their Lord, the heavenly God. He said, he will also go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? So this child that was given to this couple is an extraordinary child. Are you hearing me? You see, most times when blessing delay, God is waiting for a bigger fish.
Amen.
Oh, that amen is not too strong.
Amen.
Brother, hear me. I say my name is Pentecostal. If you don't give me amen, you make me unhappy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I need the amen, oh.
Amen.
God bless you and increase you.
Amen.
He said he will also go before him in the spirit of the power of Elijah to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just. To make a ready a people prepared for the Lord. And Zechariah said to the angel, how shall I know this? Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's asking for a sign again. Gideon said, show me a sign. Zechariah said, yes, sir. I have heard you, sir. But how will I see this? I need to see what? A sign. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, it's okay asking for a sign. But a sign may affect you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The one that came and affected this man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gideon was able to escape. But this is my brother, the one that came to him. It's a different sign, though. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hear me? When whatever you see in the word of God and you believe it, hear me, it is settled.
Amen.
Aye. Why we run from pillar to post is that we don't have the faith capacity to make the word of God of effect. Are you hearing me? Anything you catch in the scriptures and your heart believe it, hear me, it is. Hallelujah. Look at this. And Zacharias said to the angel, how shall I know this? For I am an old man. And my wife is well advanced in years. You see, most of the problem we have with God is our natural flesh speaks. The Lord said you'll be a prime minister. You look at yourself in the £5.60 job you're doing. You begin to reason, how will it happen? It is not about your job, it's about God who has spoken.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
The Lord said he has made, you see, you know, you see, understand this aspect of God. I said last time, the Lord sees you as a finished product and he speaks to you as a finished product. Hallelujah. But times, because of our situation, we look at what we are going through now and it makes us to disbelieve God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God said to Zacharias through his angel, I have intervened, I have visited you. You are going to have this blessing. And Zacharias began to rehearse his references. I am well advanced in age. My wife is this and that. Hallelujah. What has God that got to do with what God is saying? Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has promised you, yes, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to give you the paper. You're looking and say, hey, how will it be? I came from Libya. Hear me? He has no. I don't listen. Where you came from, it doesn't matter your village.
Amen.
What is important is what God is saying, not what you're saying.
Yes, yes,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Stop seeing your inabilities.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Zacharias began to say, I am one of us in age. My wife is grown up. How would this be? The flesh will not minister to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hear me. Hear me. Whatever God said he will do, your responsibility is to believe him. Okay, do you pay? Do you pay to believe God?
No.
So what is your trouble? Hallelujah.
Amen.
What's your problem? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Leave it to him. He will do it.
Amen.
Zacharias, we have to look at this situation there. You know, I am well advanced in age. You know, at this level of life, you know, this is can that happen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hear me, for God to alter your position. Whatever thing he says to you when it comes to you, whether it makes sense or does not make sense, believe him.
Amen.
And most times God will tell you things that won't make sense. Are you hearing me? That is why he himself is God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If he's able, if it makes sense, then what, his supremacy as God does not come into relevance here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? The reason why he's God is that things that does not make sense. He, look at when he created the world. The Bible said the world was without form and void. Hallelujah. He said darkness was so deep upon the surface of the earth. He said the earth has no validity. He said, let there be, and there was. Will he see your change? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord will suddenly visit you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know what you're believing God for in this season. As we enter the new year, I don't know your expectations. But hear me, we have a God that intervenes in the affairs of men in a sudden way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People will begin to announce you suddenly. Yeah, we used to know that guy. Hey, that guy, we need to work together. Are you hearing me? He may work together with him, but God has decided to do what to visit him.
Amen.
His portfolio has changed. Are you hearing me? I pray that in this coming year, the Lord will visit you as you do your own thing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what happened there. And angel answered and said to him, I am Gabriel, who stands in the presence of God. Look at that. I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of what? God. And was sent to speak to you and bring you glad tidings. May God send an angel to you.
Amen.
In this season, let there be angelic visitation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In this season, may God send an angel to you.
Amen.
Angels that will announce who you are to you.
Amen.
Angels that will define you in the right perspective.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord said to you, you are going to be an importer. And meanwhile, your uncle has no shipping company. You don't even know where the seaport is in England. Leave it to him.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Leave it to him. Leave it to him. Leave it to him.
Amen.
When the time comes, he will begin to connect.
Amen.
He will begin to connect.
Amen.
He will begin to connect.
Amen.
Stop asking too much questions. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Believe the Lord, and he will do that which he said he will do.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
You don't need to have an uncle that has a shipping company. If your uncle has a shipping company, then you don't need God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know why I'm saying this. But if you are here, you want to go into importation, I announce to you that this coming year the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
As you do your own thing, he will send an angel. Hallelujah. Hear me. We are in an era where we need to believe God against our personal situation. Hear me, your situation will always want to limit you. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? I remember the first time they told me, sir, you know, that I'm going to be a man of God. I laughed myself into stupor. Because I knew what I used to do. Hallelujah. You know, this is God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You know, I was doing my own thing. My brother, actually, who talked to me this morning, is also a man of God also in Australia. He took me, said he wants us to go to a church. I said, eh. I said, okay, let's go. For me, I was enjoying the ride because there was a new car. Amen. I wasn't interested in the church we were going because I wanted to go and enjoy the ride. I said, okay, let's go. And here comes this prophet. The man saw me, I said, hey. He was telling me, I'm going to, this guy, he won't stop listening to you. Are you hearing me? The guy was saying a lot of things. And I went behind, I went to the toilet, I started laughing, eh? This guy, me, a man of God. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? It does not make sense to me. Because I need the Bible to antagonize people who preach. Are you hearing me? Hallelujah. And here comes this one saying, man of God. You know, at times, what you do with the prophecies that comes to you determines what happened to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Some they will receive it and run with it. Others will pocket it and say, hey, he's saying again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hear me? When God speaks through his servant, this morning the Lord said somebody to me, hallelujah.
Amen.
And he said, the message was that at times we will speak these things, but people don't believe it. Hear me? When you don't operate with God, you only but delay your destiny.
Amen.
Hear me? The Lord is willing and able to do what will visit you. But how you position yourself for that visitation matters. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Have you got a blessing here?
Yes,
Zacharias began to look at himself and said, I am more advanced in age. How would this be? Hallelujah. I believe that if that man of God has saw me that day, if he see me to the preaching, maybe he will give me 24. They will put me on the table and lash me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They told me I went to the toilet and started laughing. Say, this man, is he okay? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The man told me, say, you're going to. I said, this guy doesn't understand what I say. Me, I'll explain my things. I want to read and come out and be the next guy that can defy with me. And he's saying he's going to be a man of God. Hallelujah. Hear me, God knows you until your final bus stop. And when he speaks concerning your end product, do not disbelieve him. Only cooperate. Hear me, believing God does not cost you any money.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Zacharias, you know, some of us will have missed the hours of our visitation. Do you know? Because the angel that has come to steal us up has come, and we're not believing God. But the Lord help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He said, but behold, look at this. You know, Zacharias began to negotiate with the angel. Then they said, okay, now I will show you something that will make you believe me. He said, you will be mute, which means your mouth will be zipped up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They will zip your mouth permanently. Look at this. I'll not be able to speak until the day these things take place. Because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their own time. Did you see that? He said, you did not believe my words that will be fulfilled in their own time. Not at your own time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, before God, time is eternal. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The problem, the enemy uses scientific time to manipulate us. Amen. If they told me when they told me I was going to be a millionaire, I don't have more than one shoe, sir. Are you hearing me? Jesus Christ. You won't understand these things. Hallelujah. I said, I don't, and that shoe, I'll polish it to brown. Tomorrow, I send it to black. Are you hearing me? What they were telling me. Sir, that shoe, I remember it clearly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will get it blessed. And they said to me, this is going to happen. Hear me. God does his things at his own time. When he says it, your responsibility is to believe him, and at the fullness of time, it will manifest. Hallelujah. All right. The children does not have me, but I can see them parading there. They want me to finish my message. Hallelujah. The Lord will visit you. The Lord will visit you. The Lord will visit you. In the name of Jesus. But brethren, I want to encourage you this morning. As we are waiting for sudden God's visitation, every word that comes to you, please carry that word and nurture it. It may not make sense, but at the fullness of God's time, they will make sense to you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Are we getting blessed, church? Yes, you are rubbing me of my amen, though.
Amen.
God bless you. You know, amen means we are together.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes,
when you rob me of the amen, it looks as if I'm preaching to myself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord will visit you suddenly.
Amen.
God visited Moses, a fugitive man, and he became one of the greatest pastors on earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Lord will visit you.
Amen.
Zacharias was carrying out his own business. Suddenly the Lord showed up. And his storyline changed. In this season, I prophesy to you that the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
It does not matter what the situation looks like, but Jehovah will visit you.
Amen.
And when he visits you, your situation will change.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are we getting blessed here?
Yes,
there is something about God's visitation. The Bible said Zacharias became speechless. Why? Because of what? Too much question. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't ask God too much question. When he speaks, say, thank you, sir. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Even if it does not make sense. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Imagine God telling you, maybe you're from Togo. God said, I'm going to change you. I'll make you to be from Spain. And meanwhile, you don't even have the Togo passport. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All you need to do what is to believe God. At the fullness of the time, the Lord will do what he wants to do.
Amen.
I want to show you something quickly, then I'll finish from there. Exodus chapter number 11, verses number 3. You see, when God visits you, hear me clearly, he will order your position. Hallelujah. I don't know what you're trusting God for in this season, but tonight the Lord will visit you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Look at that. He said, and the Lord gave people favor in the sight of the Egyptians. Watch this. He said, moreover, the man Moses was very great in the land of Egypt, in the sight of Pharaoh's servants, in the sight of the people. The man Moses was so great. This was a fugitive of yesterday. A man that was escaping arrest. But when God showed up, his status was altered. The Lord will change your position.
Amen.
By reason of his visit. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, Moses became so great in the sight of what Pharaoh's servants. And in the sight of all the people. You see, when God's visitation brings what? Exaltation. That's why the Bible says promotion does not come from the east. From the north or from the west, which means promotion does not come from an uncle. Are you hearing me? He said, God is the one that charges. He raises one up and another one he can bring down. But the Lord God exalt you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want us to be on our feet. Begin to thank him. I begin to thank him once again this morning. Thank him because he's about to visit you. Begin to appreciate him. Thank him because he's about to visit you. He's coming to see you through. It does not matter your situation or what you're going through, but in this season, the Lord is coming to visit you. Open your mouth and begin to appreciate him. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Appreciate him, appreciate him. Talk to him in prayer. Talk to him. Blessed be your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. While all eyes are closed, if you're here and you know you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, this is your opportunity to come forward, because God's visitation is for those who have a regenerated spirit, those He has given salvation. Hallelujah. If you're here this morning, you know your life is not worthy of God's visitation. You have an opportunity this morning to make reconciliation with Him. Hallelujah. While all eyes are closed, I want you to come forward. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within Him. Bless His holy name. He has done great things. Special people, Lord, we are praying that the word that has come forth, let that word bring your visitation. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, as they prepare to walk into next year, Lord, let there be a supernatural visitation. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, blessed be your holy name. We want to thank you, want to exalt you. Have your way, because you cannot fail. Be now exalted, my God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We're going to say for Jesus Christ. Let me see that. Amen.